else by voting no. We now have to reach out to those who voted yes and bring the country back together. But south of the border, in Northern Ireland, Wales and in England, most people wanted to stay together.
I started to worry, but now seeing this is really, it's amazing.
We've fought a great campaign. I'm immensely proud of every one of the activists who, with their heads held high, went out into the communities and made the case.
23 hours, so another hour and it'll be 24 hours up, so it's been a long day, but it's well worth it.
There was a huge turnout. A nation had spoken. There had been predictions of a knife-edge contest. Ultimately, the ballot papers told the tale. Scotland's choice was close, but it was clear. Declarations came in from 32 different areas of Scotland. And as the figures stacked up, they stacked higher for the no vote. It made for compulsive viewing, the bigger picture and the small detail. In Glasgow, police officers were on the counting floor amidst allegations of electoral fraud involving 10 votes. In Dundee, it was all about the drama. Right down to 3 fire alarms that delayed its count while everyone was evacuated outside. A nation held its breath overnight. In Glasgow's George Square, where Yes supporters had rallied over several days, they waited in hope.
The vibe that I'm getting from the Scottish community is just a total yes. And I think they would benefit from the yes, because I work from the NHS.
We'll always be part of the UK, but if we could be independent, that would just be something else. It would really be amazing.
One of the more things that I hear every day are just bad about the government, and I don't like it, because I think it's just going to keep getting worse if we don't do something about it.
Yes, 53,620. No, 39,800.
As dawn approached, so did the result. Declarations came thick and fast. In Glasgow, it came for Yes, Scotland's biggest city endorsing independence. And for Nicola Sturgeon, the SNP's deputy leader and so-called minister for the referendum, it wasn't overall victory, but it was a result.
I'm absolutely delighted. This is Scotland's biggest city and it has just voted decisively yes. I think that is hugely significant, and as a Glasgow MSP, I understand we won every single constituency in Glasgow, so it underlines the point that I think is coming through very, very loudly from the results tonight, that there is a massive appetite for change in Scotland.
Scotland's most visible politician was hard to spot on his night of defeat. Alex Salmond was keeping a low profile as he headed for Edinburgh to face the media and address questions over his future.